get some kind of like star portal in our chest that opens our heart and then beams us into another dimension or something. Like, I don't really know what it does.
Yeah, it does.
Like, everything else like secretes chemicals and hormones, and it feels like it should do something. Divulged again from the topic. But whatever it is, don't press on it, because you can actually break it.
Yeah.
So it's kind of soft, it's a little bit delicate. Don't press too hard there. So when we work on the stomach, we find where that is, and then we go an inch or two away, de-armouring these ribs. My focus is much more on the kidney. I'm almost like touching the kidney from behind, because I'm touching the nerves that go into the kidney, and then pushing on the muscles from the kidney. So you could say in that sense, I'm kind of holding his kidney. But for most of what we're doing, it's emotional, and you're going to find more emotion in here. Most people's hands, we use them so much, they ran energy quite well. The legs, and all of the time when that energy is moving, when he doesn't have a lot of emotional content, I can't feel very much from him. I have to start feeling more in myself. Otherwise, it's just the practice of his body moving. So how do I bring more energy into his body? Music can help in these senses. Smells can help. To work on the legs, and more energy is coming up. This will help them keep them.
Yeah,
exactly. In the heart, so it would come this way. And if they were more in the masculine, and I needed to get that energy moving first, where would I start? It's the energy, it's the intention that changes the information in his body. What I notice immediately is the tension and the suppression in the legs, and you can see how his legs kind of want to shake out, and how that needs to integrate onto the arm of the body, but it moves into a very energetic experience, so you just have to go with the body. Often what we see is from the heart, we want love to be expressed, but really pain comes out. And this is why we don't open it, we don't express it. My body, I can share and project to him. That's non-dual healing. I'm sharing my frequency and my vibration, but so he can find himself. I'm not dominating him, I'm not giving him my energy. It's just letting your body's align to a higher state. It's always a gray area. I mean to contradict myself, but it's slightly contradictory. But what I'm not doing is putting my energy into his body. Or just giving him one piece of spiritual knowledge which activates his kundalini. I really massage it, I warm everything up before I press in. Just because it's a demonstration, we're doing things slightly differently. You need to feel like your aura, your energetic field, let the energy come out your body, let it come out through the...
Yeah, and then I felt it. I felt the energy, I felt things changing, and after 2 years and a half now, I wanted to know more. I had a really great time, I laughed a lot, I was happy all the time here. For me, everybody's personal different, but for me it was like, yeah, I'm going to change the world, and it was like, of course, this is it. We can all think that we are wise in a way, and everybody has a certain wisdom, but nobody has all the wisdom. Together we have more wisdom.
Experience a lot, even in the yoga in the morning, it's getting more and more each day, so I really would have liked to do 7 more days or something like that to increase it.
I'm definitely ready to get a session. Yeah. I would like to do it actually. It's good work.
And I at the beginning asked to change the experience, and I think I got it really. And he teaches, it's great, he's a great teacher. But, he helps people, and he's in it. not like a teacher teach from above. So she teaches from eye to eye, and not a protocol, not structure so much that you can do it in this way, but you can do it on your own way as well.